Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Let's play the famous organic chemistry game, aromatic or aliphatic. Example one, toluene. We have a flat ring with atoms that have p orbitals with 6 total electrons. It's just like benzene. Yes, toluene is aromatic. Now what about this methyl group? The methyl group is not aromatic, but the ring is. If a molecule contains an aromatic ring, then the molecule is aromatic. Parts of it, like the methyl group, might not be aromatic. Even with non-aromatic parts, toluene is still an aromatic molecule. Example number two, 1-methoxy naphthalene. We do have a ring, but now there are 2 rings. Don't complicate this. Just look at this molecule as having one big ring instead of 2 little ones. The big ring is flat, and all the atoms are sp2 hybridized, so they all have a p orbital. How many electrons in this big ring? We have 5 pi bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 10 electrons. 10 equals 4n plus 2. N equals 2. That is a non-negative integer, so this ring is aromatic. Just like with toluene, the side group, the methoxy, has no impact. This molecule is aromatic. Example 3, this molecule. We have a ring. Small rings can always be flat if needed. The problems begin with this carbon right here. If we draw in the hydrogens, we see that it is sp3 hybridized. Pro tip, even though the hydrogens are not drawn, do not forget they are there. Therefore, every atom in the ring does not have a p orbital. Regardless of whether the other criteria are satisfied, this molecule is not aromatic. It is aliphatic. Example 4, imidazole. We have a ring and it can be flat. Can each atom in the ring be sp2 hybridized to give each a p orbital? The carbons are fine with sp2. The nitrogen in the upper right is fine as sp2. It's on a double bond. It's the bottom nitrogen that is a question. If the lone pair is in a p orbital, then it can be sp2. Let's draw the structure with some perspective to demonstrate what we've been discussing. There's a nitrogen on the right, that right-hand nitrogen, we gave it a p orbital. Okay, now let's think about electrons. We have 2 double bonds. That's the carbon-nitrogen pi bond. That's 2 electrons. We have a carbon-carbon pi bond. That's 2 more electrons. And this nitrogen lone pair, there isn't much space, but we can try to cram 2 electrons in there. And that's 6 electrons. Now, there is one question. This nitrogen that I've circled up here, it has a lone pair. Where are those electrons in our picture to the right? Well, that lone pair is going to be in an sp2 hybrid. It's perpendicular to the p orbitals. So this has 6 electrons, 4 in the pi bonds, 2 in that one lone pair in the p orbital. 6 equals 4n plus 2, n equals 1. This molecule, imidazole, is aromatic. There we have it, 4 quick examples of applying Huckel's rules to determine whether a molecule is aromatic or aliphatic.